फ्लेम फोटोमेट्री। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल गोइंग टू नो अबाउट फ्लेम फोटोमेट्री। फ्लेम फोटोमेट्री, फर्स्ट कमिंग टू द डेफिनेशन, डेफिनेशन सेज दैट इट इज़ अ टेक्निक दैट डील्स विद स्टडी ऑफ एमिटेड रेडिएशन इन फ्लेम बाय एलिमेंट एंड इट्स कोरिलेशन ऑफ इंटेंसिटी विद कंसंट्रेशन। सपोज वी हैव अ पार्टिकल एंड वी डू नॉट नो दैट वट इट इज़ मेड अप ऑफ। इट Either it is made up of sodium, potassium or calcium, we do not know about this. So what we will going to do, we will going to put it in the flame and we will going to see what radiations this particle is emitting. If it is emitting a radiation that is of white light, so we can say that this particle consists of zinc element and this intensity, the intensity of the white light will directly proportional to the concentration of zinc present in this particle. So this is all about flame photometry. Now coming to the applications of flame photometry. So here are the some applications of flame photometry. That flame photometry is used in cement industry for estimation of sodium oxide, calcium oxide, potassium oxide. It is also used in glass industry for estimation of sodium, potassium, boron, lithium. Third, it is used in petroleum industry for determination of lead, manganese. Fourth, it is used in biological fluids like your blood, urine. If we want to determine the sodium, potassium or calcium concentration, we can also use flame photometry. Fifth, it is used in soil analysis for determination of sodium, potassium and calcium. Now one thing you can see, the sodium, potassium and calcium is coming many times in all of these. If we leave only petroleum, it is only have lead and manganese, otherwise all four having sodium, potassium, calcium. So it is very easy to remember this. All you need to remember is these industries. Sixth and last, it determine elements like copper, iron. So this is the applications of flame photometry. Now you can take a screenshot to remember all of these.